Greetings! Today's biology lesson is about some plant vermins that can be found in the orchard. Now, big producers in our days use chemical substances to get rid of the vermins. But if you want to make a natural production, you will meet the enormous amount of vermins that will ruin the crops. And now I will again use a fun game, because this lesson should be interactive, where I will shake the fruits and vegetables from the garden to see what vermins are there. Okay, let's begin with the orchard trees, and let me shake that apple and see what came out of it. This is a codding moth. Now, codding moth are type of butterflies that nest in the apple, and their offspring worms eat the apple. So if you see butterflies around the apple, this is not good. The next orchard tree is the cherry tree, and let's see what could come out from the cherry. And that is a cherry fruit fly. Again, cherry fruit flies nest in the cherries, and their little worm offsprings are eating the cherry from inside. Also, there are a lot of flies in the garden, so it may be difficult to recognize them. And let's see another ripped fruit. That is the plum, and we got that plum wasp. Again, the wasp nest in the plum, ensuring food for its offsprings. Now, all these three vermins can be exterminated by chemical substances that are applied with with a stream on the trees. I should train that more. But let me go and see the flower of the apple. Now, while the apples are flowering, there are a lot of dangerous stages while it develops into an apple. And we can see there this Anthonomus pomorum. This is a kind of beetle that nests near the apple flowers and eats the flowers. That is. And I will shake another flowering region here in the orchard trees to see these red spider mites. Well, red spider mites can infest the whole tree, and they're actually a very big problem for small gardeners. That is, now if it is not chemically treated, the spider mites can be removed physically, but this takes a lot of time, and if the orchard is big, it is almost impossible to remove spider mites by physical means. Alright, so while I'm here, I'm checking outside of the garden, here in the fields, where we grow the wheat. And the wheat is often attacked by wheat thrips. This is a small flexible insects that are destroying the wheat. Okay, I'm back in the garden to check the vegetables now. Or fruits. Now, tomato, some in different regions, tomato is either vegetable or fruit. And I think I plan to make a game where we will divide fruit and vegetables, and the tomato will be an interesting example. But let me shake it, and I have find here the tomato aphid. Now, that tomato aphid is not only infesting the tomatoes, but everything that they can reach. You can see these aphids in clusters on the plants. Again, like red spider mites, they are very difficult to get rid of without chemical means. But again, if you want a natural garden, you should avoid using chemical means. That is when the harvest is for own consumption. And I'm moving to check what is there here in my garden. And I found this potato. Yes, potato plant. Let me shake it. And from there I see the Colorado beetle. Very popular insect that like to eat potato leaves. And eating the leaves, it blocks the energy that the root, which is actually the potato, will need to grow and become a good potato. I believe, and I'm sure, and I'm doing it, Colorado beetles can be removed by physical means if it is that house garden, of course, if it is a big field of potatoes, it will be impossible to remove by physical means. And I'm continuing to the cabbage. I want to make a nice cabbage salad. And while I pick up the leaves, I found this Philotreta. This is a nasty, small, shiny beetles that like to eat cabbage before it is made on salad. So we have to be careful. Again, this may be removed by physical means if the garden is small enough. Right, so I got just one more vermin to find, and I can find it here where I have placed my carrots. Shaking, and we got the snow beetle. Snow beetle. A beetle that like to eat carrots and like to nest in the carrots. Now, I don't have a lot of these snout beetles, so the carrots in this garden are actually growing pretty well. So this is for today in our botany lesson. That is a branch of biology. Now I feel educated, so I can go and play games. Games, games, games.